Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. All of you have learned about the options for the standard toolbar used with Impress in the first class of this module. Let us now revise what you have learned in the first class. Why is the standard toolbar used? Using the standard toolbar, you can create shortcuts for the options of the menu bar so that you can use these directly. You can add those options here which you need to use repeatedly in your Impress file. For instance, new, open, save, hyperlink, etc. can all be kept in the standard toolbar. How can you hide and unhide the various options of the standard toolbar? In order to hide and unhide the options of the standard toolbar, you need to click on the control button or the drop-down option which has been highlighted in the picture being shown in front of you. Then you will need to use the option for customized toolbar to hide or unhide the options of the standard toolbar. Do you remember what is the display grid? With the use of the display grid, you can get to see many dots on your Impress slide or view it as a graph. Do you know why is the chart option used? Using the chart option, you can show your Excel data like the records of someone or a list as a chart within Impress. Do you know what happens with the use of the option for print file directly? Using the print file directly option, you can directly print your Impress file. Now, turn on your computers and then open your Impress file. And let us now begin today's class. All of you should first type out the given paragraph on your first slide. Next, go ahead and format this paragraph. Have you all finished formatting the paragraph or no? Let us now watch this video and see how all this formatting can be done. With the help of this video, we are going to practice and learn how we can do the formatting on our Impress slide where there is some text. As you can see, this slide has some text and we want to do formatting on this using the icons available here in the formatting toolbar. So, for doing the formatting, first we need to select the line or the text or the paragraph on which we want to apply the formatting. You can select the text or the line using any of the methods, the mouse, touchpad or the keyboard. After having selected the line, let's try to change the style of the font type. So, we can click on the drop-down button in the font type icon and look for the font that we like. As soon as we select the font of our choice, that gets applied on the line or the text or the paragraph that we had chosen. Let's select another part of this slide. As you can see, we have selected the second paragraph also, and let's see how we can change the size of the font or the font size. So when you click on the drop down button here, right now we have changed it to 44 size. If you want to change it back to a different size, you have to click on the drop down button again, choose the size you want, let's say 32, and it changes to 32. Next, let's select the text once again. We have selected the text from the second paragraph. And let's now click on the icon for bold. So once we click on B, the bold icon, this text which we have selected becomes bold. It becomes thicker and darker. Select the first line and let's try to use the underline icon. So as soon as you click on the underline icon, the selected text gets a line under it or it gets underlined. Let's do some more formatting. Let's select the second paragraph. And let us now, we've just selected the two lines of the second paragraph. Let's change the font color. So from the font color, click on the drop-down button. You see many colors. Choose the one that you like. Select that by clicking on it. And you will see that the same color gets applied on the selected text, line or paragraph. Let's select the last line also and change the font color for this also by clicking on the drop down button of the font color icon and selecting a different color for it. As is being shown in the video, we are now selecting a different shade of red. So this is how we can do various formatting. Let's also just put the cursor in the beginning of the first line and apply a bullet using the bullets icon. Click on the bullets, you can see bullets being applied. So this way you can use formatting on this text. Next, bring up another new slide. Can you tell in how many ways you can insert a new slide? You can insert a new slide in two ways. In the first method, you can go to the insert option of the menu bar and select the slide option to insert a new slide. In the second method, you can right click on your mouse or touchpad and then select the new slide option to insert a new slide. Now use the drawing toolbar to draw a rectangular box on this slide and change its formatting as is being shown in the picture to you. In case you have any doubts, then you can learn by watching the video. With the help of this video, we are going to first insert a new slide and then drag a rectangle in it and do some formatting on the rectangle. So to get a new slide, you have to take your pointer to the slide pane, right click on it and then choose the new slide option and you will get a new slide. You can also use the insert menu in the menu bar to get a new slide. Now you can see that this slide is a title slide, whereas you want a blank slide. So go to the layouts in the slide layout and click on the blank slide option. So you will have a blank slide. Now from the drawing toolbar, let's select a tool which we want to use. Since we want to use drag a rectangle, since we want to make a rectangle, we choose the rectangle tool and drag a rectangle as is being shown in the video. Select the rectangle so that we can do some formatting on it. First, let's change the outline style. So when you click on the drop down button, you see many styles available. Select one and that gets applied on your rectangle's outline. You can increase the width by clicking on the up arrow here. And you can also change the color of the outline, as we have done, as we have shown in the video. Now to fill inside, you have to click on the drop down button of color. Let's select gradient colors. And when you click on the drop down button here, you see many gradients are available. So there is a wide variety of gradients available. select the one which you like and it gets applied on your rectangle. So this way you can insert a new slide on your Impress file, get a rectangle and do the formatting on it. Now insert another slide and then insert a 5x5 table in it. Also, type some data in this table. Watch the video to see how a table can be made on an Impress slide. Let us now watch this video and learn how we can insert a new slide and create a table on our Impress file. So to do this, first of all, we need to right click on the slide pane so that we can get a new slide. We take our pointer or the cursor onto the slide pane to the second slide, right click on it and then select the new slide. So since the second slide was a blank slide, the new slide also is a blank slide. Now we have to insert a table. So we can just go to the standard toolbar table icon, click there and you see a box opening for insert table. Here you can define the number of columns and the number of rows you want. Since we want 5x5, we have selected 5x5, click on OK and you can see a table gets inserted. You can see the dots on the sides of the table. You can use them to increase or decrease the size of the table. Now let's type in some data in the table. So in the first column, first row, let's type SN, which is for serial number. And then we are going to fill up this table with some data so that you also come to know that we can use this table on our Impress file. So in the first column, we have typed serial number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Bring your cursor to the first column, second row, first row of this and the second column, and let's type the title name. And in this row, in this column, we are going to be typing the names. So we have typed number one name as Pankaj, second one is Tarun, it might show you this red curved line below some names because it may not recognize it as an English word. These are names. Then we have typed Rohit, then we have typed Arun. Now in the third column, in the first row, let's type a title. Since we want this to be qualification, we need a bigger column. So we have just placed our cursor on the line and then keeping the left button pressed, we have dragged it towards the right side so that the column width has increased. Now let's type the title qualification and put the qualification of all these students. What exam or what degree have they already got? So we have typed BA for Pankaj. For Tarun, we are typing BCom. For Rohit, let's type 12th. And for Arun, let's type BSc. So we have given the qualification. Next column, the fourth column, again we want to increase the width. So we take the cursor to the line here as is being shown in the video and drag it towards the right by keeping the left button of the mouse or the touchpad pressed down. And here we are typing the email ID. These are just examples. So we can type, let's say pan@gmail.com. If you have correct data, you should make sure that you enter the right data. Otherwise, when you use the table, things can go wrong. So you should make sure that you are typing the right data. For the next student, we have typed tar@gmail.com again. As you know, these are just examples. For Rohit, we are typing roh@gmail.com. And in the last row, which is the fourth student, Arun, we are typing arun@gmail.com. And in the last column, once again, since the width is very small, we will click on the right side line and drag it towards the right side so that the width of the fifth column, the last column, also increases. Let's type some contact number for all these students. These are the kind of details that you would use in an actual table. You would have the name, you would have serial number, you can have marks, you can have qualifications, you will need maybe address, email ID, and just like we are typing some contact number. These are just examples. So we are typing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. For the first one, for the second one, we have done 765431, and similarly for the third and the fourth student. So this is how you can create a new slide, create a table, and type data within that table on your Impress file. Can you change the design of the table? Let us now learn with the help of this video how you can change the design of the table. With the help of this video, let us practice the use of changing the table design. So, first select the table option from the properties, and you can see different types of table designs are available. As soon as you click on a different design, your table changes to that design. So you can try and click on different types of designs that you may like, and you can settle down on the one which you like. This way you can change the design of the table that you have on your Impress slide. It's very easy to change the design from the available designs. Next, insert another slide and show how you will use the hyperlink option to create a link in this file to another file. Let us learn by watching this video how the hyperlink option is applied on the Impress file to create a link to another file. By watching this video, we are going to now learn how we can insert another new slide and insert a hyperlink in the new slide. We can actually insert the hyperlink on any of the slides of our Impress file, but since we want to insert a new slide and insert the hyperlink there, let us take our cursor to the slide pane, right click on it, and then click on the new slide option. As is being shown in the video, you get a new slide. Now you want to insert a hyperlink on this. Take the cursor to the hyperlink icon in the standard toolbar, click on it, and the hyperlink options box opens. Select the documents from here and then click on the open file icon. A box opens which tells you or shows you different address locations of the files on your computer. So you should know where your file is. If our file is on desktop, we select desktop and then look for a file, select the file, and then click on open. As soon as you click on open, this box will close, and in the hyperlink option, you can see that the link has come. The path has been given there. Click on apply. However, if by chance, like in this case, the path has got deleted, you have to open file again. Click on the open file icon, select desktop, and properly select the file that you were looking for. We have the Impress class 1 file, which is a PDF file. Click on open. Note that the links have come now. Click on apply. So those links get applied on our Impress slide, and then click on close. You can see the hyperlink has been made. Now if you want to open the hyperlink, bring your cursor here. Keep the control button pressed with your left hand and press the left button on the mouse or the keypad, and your PDF file will open. As you can see, this is the PDF file, and you can use it when you want it. Then later you can close this PDF file and get back to your Impress slides or the Impress file to work further on it. This is how you will open a new slide and apply a hyperlink to any file that you want to use on your Impress file. Next, go ahead and show how you will copy and paste the third and the fourth slide. In case you face a problem, learn how to do this by watching the video. By watching this video, let us now learn how you can copy and paste one or more than one slides from your Impress file. So if you want to select two slides, you have to keep the control button pressed with your left hand, click on the third slide, and then keeping the control button pressed, click on the fourth slide also. So you can see in the slide pane, both slide 3 and 4 have been selected. Go to the standard toolbar copy icon and click there, and these two slides have now got copied. You can also use the shortcut command Ctrl plus C. Now, if you go to paste icon and click there, you will see that both these files, both these slides get copied as number 5 and number 6 slide. You can see now there are 6 slides. 3 is the same as 5 and 4 is the same as 6. So this way you can use copy and paste on your slides in the Impress file. Now use undo and tell what happens when you use undo. Next, use the redo command and also say what happened when you used it. Let us watch the video and understand what happens when we use the undo and redo commands. In this video, we will practice the use of undo and redo on the Impress file. So remember that in the last thing that we had done was inserted or copy pasted two slides. So if we go to the undo button in the standard toolbar, click on that, you notice in the slide pane that slide number 5 and 6 have disappeared. So there are only 4 slides now in your Impress file. If you want to bring back the 5th and the 6th slide, all you have to do is go to the redo icon in the standard toolbar and click on it. And the 5th and the 6th slide will come back as is being shown in the video. Click there and you can see that the 5th slide, which is a copy of the 3rd, and the 6th slide, which is a copy of the 4th slide, has reappeared or has come back. So this way you can use undo and redo on your Impress file. Next, all of you go ahead and show how you will hide some of the options of the standard toolbar, like those for new, hyperlink, display grid, copy, paste, undo, and redo. In case you come across a problem, then watch the video and understand how these options of the standard toolbar can be hidden. With the help of watching this video, we are now going to see how we can hide or unhide options of the standard toolbar. As you can see, the various standard toolbar options are visible. So let's say if we want to hide these options, new, hyperlink, display grid. So these are the options that we want to hide. So we are just looking up these options. We want to hide paste also. We want to hide undo. So what we have to do now is to take our cursor or the pointer to the right side of the standard toolbar drop and click on the drop down button. Select the customized toolbar. A box opens. Make sure that you select the toolbars option, and in the toolbar, the standard toolbar is selected. Now, where the tick marks are shown are the options which are being shown in the standard toolbar. Since we want to hide the new option, we have unselected it. Similarly, we scroll down and we unselect the options that we want to hide. So we are unselecting copy. We are unselecting paste. Let's also unselect some other options. Let's scroll down. Let's unselect this one also. Can't undo and can't restore. So all these options that we have unselected will no longer be visible in our standard toolbar. Let's also unselect display grid and hyperlink. So we have unselected hyperlink. We've unselected display grid. Then just click on OK. And all the options that you have unselected get hidden. You can see the standard toolbar on your Impress file has become smaller, and all those options that you have unselected are no longer there. To get them back, you will again go to the drop down button and use customize toolbar, and then show how you will save this file on the desktop. Learn by watching the video how your file can be saved on the desktop. Let us now watch this video and understand how we can use the save icon in the standard toolbar to save our Impress file. So in order to save this file, we need to take our cursor to the save icon of the standard toolbar. Click there and a box opens which shows you the address location on your computer where you want to save your file. So you should know where you want to save. For instance, you can save it on desktop, in downloads, in documents. So since we want to save it on desktop, let's select desktop, and then in this file name, you can delete whatever name is appearing there and type in the name that you want. So this name that you type in will be the name with which this file will get saved in the desktop. So we are typing the class name as class2. Class-2. Then we click on save. As soon as you click on save, you can see in the title bar that this file has now been saved as class-2. If you want to see where it has been saved, you have to first minimize this Impress file on which you were working. So minimize it and then look in the desktop, because we had saved it in desktop, and see that your file has indeed been saved with the name of class-2. You can see this file as is being shown in the video to you. You can come back to your Impress file by clicking on the taskbar. Can you tell in how many ways you can convert this file into the PDF format? You can convert an Impress file in two ways into the PDF format. In the first method, you will go to the file option of the menu bar and use the export as PDF or the export option to convert your file into PDF format. The second method you can use is to use the PDF option of the standard toolbar. This is also being shown to you in the picture in front of you. So now use the standard toolbar to convert your file into the PDF format. If you still have any doubts in doing this, then watch the video and learn how this is done. Watch this video now to see how you can directly convert your Impress file into a PDF file by using the icons in the standard toolbar. So to convert this file to PDF format, all you have to do is take your pointer to the PDF icon or the PDF button in the standard toolbar. Click there. The box for location opens. This is the address bar is there. So you know where you want to save it. So let's say you want to save it in desktop. Select desktop and then key in the file name. For instance, we have typed in Impress class 2 and then click on save. And this file will directly get converted into PDF format and be saved on the desktop. To see this, minimize the current file and look on the desktop. You can see that the Impress class 2 file as PDF is existing on the desktop. Double click on it and the PDF file will open and you can view this file and you can work with this file. However, since this is a PDF file, it is a secure file, which means that you cannot make any changes. You can't do any editing on this. Once again, if you want to go back to your Impress file, you can close this PDF file and then from the taskbar, look for your Impress file. Click on that to open that file. This is how you can directly convert your Impress file to PDF format. Since we will end today's class here, all of you close your file and then properly shut down your computers. In today's class, all of you revised what you had already learned about the various options of the standard toolbar like save, copy, paste, print file directly, undo, redo, table, hyperlink and grid display, and also practice their use. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.